Does the beast attract the hunter to them?
Yes.
To go back to the non-physical, that's fine with them?
To be part of the process. In other words, by the hunter, it sounded as if you meant the human hunter. Mm-hmm. Or did you mean the...
I meant the human hunter. I think of them as pure positive energy, and I know that the murderer and the murderee attract each other to each other. Then how can something that has pure positive energy, such as a beast, attract somebody that's going to kill it?
It's interesting. Your terminology is very good, very telling. As physical beings hunt, the label murderer seems to apply. Mm-hmm. As the lion hunts, you are less willing to, then it's survival of the fittest.
The lion's not going to put him up on the wall like the hunter would. So, I see that the lion has to hunt to survive. I don't see that the hunter has to hunt to survive. That's my differentiation.
And it is a good one. Often physical humans will say, Abraham, will there ever be a time when man will not hunt for food or for trophy? In other words, when the hunting will stop? And we say, it is conceivable that you could get enough laws and enough rules and enough enforcers of them that you could stop anybody from doing anything publicly. They will always do it privately. But we don't think you would ever get a consensus among the animals. In other words, the big fish will continue to eat the small fish, and the lion will continue to eat the gazelle. In other words, and the reason is because it is all part of the process of perpetuation. It's part of the expansion of the experience. And because the animal understands that there is no death, there is no separation in consciousness, the animal does not see death as a bad thing. See, and maybe the hunter doesn't either. Maybe the hunter understands the perpetuation of that. Maybe the hunter understands that there is balance in all things. Maybe the hunter even has some sense of non-physical influence that is inspiring the hunt. In other words, there are many parts of your population where the deer are becoming more than the population is wanting to support. And Esther has only recently stopped yelling, run, Bambi, run, as she drives through the neighborhood and sees the deer and the hunters. In other words, she is finally coming into alignment that it is all right, that these beasts are coming forth in order to support the perpetuation. In other words, where do you draw these lines? From the non-physical, you know that there is life in all things. And from the non-physical, you understand that as much life is breathed into and pulses through the apple as the Bambi. Mm-hmm. You see what we're getting at? So when you come into harmony to understand that all is well and that this balance is consistent and you no longer are pushing against anything but flowing with it, then you find yourself maybe even being a hunter and being in harmony with core energy.